Now let's explore some basic operations pertaining to the PyData archive. First, let's explore the way we can figure out the version of the PyData archive. To do this, let's open up PySystem Management Tool from Start, All Programs, PySystem, and selecting PySystem Management Tools. Then go to Operations and click on PyVersion. Here, you would note that the version of the PyData archive, for example, it is 3.4.3.90.16, and it is a 64-bit PyData archive as well. Furthermore, as in this example, you would also be able to ascertain if certain patches have been applied properly. In this case, we can confirm that the patches that were supposed to be applied to certain subsystems were indeed applied. For example, in this patch, we had a patch for the PyNet Manager, PyBase subsystem, and PyArchive subsystem. Now, let's next click on the so-called PyServices, which is this, which is also under Operations. Here, you would note quite a few services that are running. These are all subsystems that make the PyData archive, and each service or subsystem is vested with a specific responsibility. For example, there is something called an archive subsystem, which stores and serves the data after it comes from the snapshot system. There is a license manager, which maintains the license information that you have for your PyData archive. There is a message subsystem, for example, that records status and errors pertaining to the PyData archive in log files. There is a network manager subsystem, which manages communication between the PyData archive subsystem, interfaces, and client applications. And like that, you have other subsystems. For example, snapshot subsystem, which we discussed earlier, to name a few. So all these subsystems work in unison to make the functionality of your PyData archive. Finally, it is also important to remember that in order to stop and start the PyData archive, one should not start and stop these services or subsystems at random, as to avoid corruption. To assist you in stopping and starting the PyData archive, we have two scripts, namely PySRVStart and PySRVStop. And these scripts are residing in PyADM folder. So let's go to the PyADM folder and see what these scripts are. Go to C, and we know that we have the PyData archive installed under C program files, py, and we need to look into the administrator folder. And if you scroll down, we will see two scripts, namely the PySRVStart for starting the PyData archive, and likewise, PySRVStop.bat for stopping the PyData archive. So let's open up the services panel. And if I just highlight one of them and click P on the keyboard, it should take you to all Py related services on your machine. And in that, you can see all the subsystems have been started and currently working. As you can see here in the Service Manager plugin, the PyData Archive subsystem services are set to type automatic. This means that your PyData Archive will automatically turn on when the server itself is started. Thus, you will only need to use the PySRVStart.bat if you stopped your PyData Archive without shutting down the entire machine and you need to turn back on the PyData Archive. These scripts are also useful for stopping and starting the PyData archive for configuration changes that require the PyData archive to be offline. So now let's try to stop the PyData archive. So let's open up the command prompt and navigate to the PyServer environmental variable. And let's go to the subfolder with ADM. And I can stop my PyData archive by executing the command py srv stop.bat. Now you can see the py data archive subsystems are shutting down in the appropriate order as specified by the pysrv stop.bat script. Now that the scripts have finished executing, let's go back and see by refreshing the services. And as you can see, we have all the services have been stopped for py data archive. Now let's do the reverse and start the py data archive by executing the command py srv start. Now let's go back again and refresh the services panel. And lo and behold, all the services have been started. And these have been started in the proper order which is required for the functionality of the PyData archive.